Hallelujah. Oh, come on, praise the Lord, everybody. Let's give God praise in this house. Oh, magnify the Lord with me and let us exalt his name together. Oh, this poor man cried and the Lord heard him and delivered him out of all of his troubles. If God has ever delivered you from anything, I want you to open up your mouth and give God some praise. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, come on and praise him in the cyber sanctuary. Give him glory that's due his name. He's a mighty good God. He's worthy of your worship. There's none like him in all the earth. Hallelujah. Well, there is no better place to be than Perfecting Church at 3. Facebook and YouTube, we're so happy that you are joining us today. We would ask you that you would please share this service right now. If you just hit that share button and let somebody know that Perfecting Church is on, this is your opportunity to evangelize and share the gospel of Jesus Christ. We are so happy that you have allowed us to come into your homes and that you chose to worship with us today. Again, there is no better place to be than Perfecting Church at 3. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we honor you today. We glorify your holy name. You're worthy of all of our worship. Father, we just pray now that in the midst of this service that you would take free course. God, have your way in the midst of this service. Move by your power. Let your glory be revealed. Manifest yourself to these thy people. Heal in the name of Jesus. Set free and deliver. Oh God, we pray for another word on this afternoon. Give us revelation knowledge of your word. Look on our pastor, dear God. Anoint him from on high. We need your power in this place. Oh, shake this place in the name of Jesus. Father, your word declares that the heaven dropped and the earth shook in your presence. Oh, Father, shake this place till we shake off everything that's offensive to you. Move by your power. Let your glory be revealed. And we give you all of the praise and all of the honor in Jesus' name. Everyone said amen and amen. How many came to praise God? How many came to lift him up? You came to give him glory that's due his name. You came to tell him that you love him, that you adore him. That's why we're here. Let's say amen for the praise and worship.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, let's clap your hands. Hallelujah. How many don't need the Holy Ghost and fire?
fire. Hallelujah. I want a revival. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Well, we are so excited with what God is doing with our young people around here at Perfecting Church. Hallelujah. As the young people would say, their worship this morning was fire. Hallelujah. And we're just so excited to see what God is going to continue to do with them. I want you to put your hands together right now for the PYCs under the leadership of Amir Healy.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I need the Holy Ghost. Jeremiah said it's like fire shut up in my bones. Hallelujah. Well, in Galatians, Paul talks about us being adopted by God and us being called the sons and daughters of God, where we have this wonderful privilege to call him Abba, Father. And I think that's such an intimate thing, such an intimate relationship, to be able to have the honor and the privilege to call God Father. Whatever I need you to be, you're there. Whenever I need you, you're there, because he's Abba. So we just want you to lift your hands and love on Jesus tonight.
Lord, we thank you for your presence. Oh yeah.
Yeah.
matter, cause your thoughts, they define me. You're inside of me. You are my reality. You're so real to me, Jesus. So glad I know you. So glad I know.
Y'all help me say,
Holy Spirit, you are welcome. Why don't you come flood this place? We want your glory. It's what my heart longs for. I belong to you. will do. No, no, because I belong to you.
Last time.
Hallelujah. Come on, give God glory. Wonderful job. Wonderful job. Is it indeed an honor and a privilege to present to some and introduce the others, the pastor and founder of Perfected Church, Bishop-elect Marvin L. Winans.
Come on and give God praise. Come on and praise Him for our young people. I'm so excited.
Holy Spirit, thou bud, you're welcome here. Come and flood this place, flood the atmosphere.
They looking at me like I didn't used to be their age. That's when I started singing. Well, before then. But that's when I started coming into my own. Because the song of the Lord, you should carry that with you in school. My. All right. Yes. Father, it is the entrance of thy word that bringeth light and life, and we pray that the glorious light of the gospel of Jesus Christ would shine bright as always. May the people be blessed by thee, never impressed by me. Cause through the revelation of thy word, these thy people, to see you more clearly, to love you more dearly, and to follow you more nearly. And now, Lord, let the words of my mouth, the meditation of my heart, be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. And every glad heart said amen. I need somebody to put their hands together and give God a shout. Everything that I need is in Him. Somebody asked the questions, why? Let's go down. What key you in?
Why should I feel discouraged? And why should the shadows come? Why should my heart be lonely and long for heaven and home?
Y'all gonna learn these songs.
When Jesus is my portion and a constant friend is He, His eyes are on the sparrow, and I know He watches me. I sing because I'm happy. You sing, but I sing because I'm free. He made me free. His eye is on the
the sparrow, and I know he watches me. Matthew 11. And then we're going to go to 1 Corinthians 12 to conclude what we want to talk about today. If you have Matthew 11, 28, indicate by shouting, amen. Amen. Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. We ought to still be shouting from that this morning. Let's go to 1 Corinthians 12, and I want to read the fourth verse. Now there are diversities of gifts, but the same Spirit. And there are differences of administrations, but the same Lord. Let's look at the sixth verse. And there are diversities of operations, but it is the same God which worketh all in all. This morning, our message was the gospel of inclusion. Look at your neighbor and say, the gospel of inclusion and diversity. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. We are bombarded with phrases and things that are being thrown at us. And I want to say, as the Apostle Paul said, in Philippians, he said, you got to know that I am set as a defense for the gospel. Were any of y'all here this morning? Amen. I just feel like I'm starting all over. I know the choir was. Y'all say amen, won't y'all? Thank you so much, young people. Paul writes in the first letter of Philippians, he begins to talk about how those that are outside of the circumstance take the scenario that he's in because he was a prisoner and used it as an embarrassment to him, and talked about his bonds in the palace and all other places. Because sometimes God will put you in an inexplicable situation where folk on the outside are wondering, how can God be with you when you're facing so much turbulence? And folk in the church, especially those that don't care for you, or those that take occasion when things aren't going well for you to prove or try to prove that God is not with you. And Paul just had to come right out and tell them, say, now, some preach Christ, of pretense, supposing to add affliction to my bonds. They talking about me because they want to hurt me. They want to embarrass me. And that's because they don't know that God set up this whole situation. I feel like I'm preaching already now. It is so vanilla of you to think that God only has one flavor. And to think that your flavor is the only flavor that God likes. The one preached Christ of contention, not sincerely supposing to add affliction to my bonds, but the other of love, knowing that I am set for the defense of the gospel. And it takes defense, as Chuck Daly taught us. It takes defense to do what? Win championships. Not just win games, but to win championships. And so we're fighting to win. And the enemy may be able to outscore you, but he can't win if you have a good defense. You can score 143 points. But if I score 144, I'm the champion. So the enemy wants you to look at the volume. And he doesn't want you to pay attention to detail. Paul says, I'm set up for the defense of the gospel. Because we're going to win some championships. So I got to stop the enemy from slipping in and coming in with false doctrine and things that's going to cause us to lose traction, to take three steps forward and five backwards. We got to set up a defensive line. That does not allow the enemy to infiltrate and to take back territory that we have. I know I just need you to stay with me a few more minutes. It may seem like I'm all over the map, but I'm not. When we read the Bible and understand the hermeneutical aspect of the Bible, we have to understand that the Christos, or the Christian philosophy or teaching, was new to that age. They could not start the New Testament church until after Jesus was resurrected. Now, there are religions that are millennials older than what we know as Christianity. And so at the beginning, God had to establish some things. I feel like preaching here. He had to establish some things so that the concept of being redeemed by the blood of the Lamb could move forward. The church started with 120 persons of Jewish descent locked up in the upper room. But that was just the beginning. God always had a global, universal view for his church. Yay! And the way he established it He told everybody. Paul tells us that there were 500 that saw him after he was resurrected. He was seen, physically seen, of about 500 brethren. When he got up out of the grave, 500 people saw him. And those 500 people that saw him believed somewhat in him. He was only seen of the disciples. Got it? And he told those disciples, y'all go back to Jerusalem and tarry. Stay there till you receive the promise of the Father. Well, I'm getting ready to lose it. When they took attendance of the 500 that saw him, they reported there was only 120 that showed up. This is massive, and I need you to understand, because what happened from the very day that the Holy Ghost fell gives clue as to who he was trying to reach. So when we read Acts 2, and they spake in other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance, that fifth verse says, and there were dwelling at Jerusalem Jews, devout men, out of every nation under heaven. Every nation. 120 Jews in a room, but every nation was represented. Because the goal of the gospel is to convert everybody. I know they, in their small thinking, thought they were the only ones, but Jesus tried to tell them, after you receive the power of the Holy Ghost, then you're going to be witnesses of me in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in Samaria. Here's what they missed. And the uttermost parts. The uttermost parts of the earth. Look at your neighbor and say diversity. Gospel was always inclusive. But it had to start somewhere with somebody. Hey. When we look in Acts 2, he says, as they begin to speak in other tongues, the sixth verse says, and now when this was noised abroad, the multitude came together and were confounded because that every man heard them speak in his own language. Y'all not giving God enough credit. Every man heard his own dialect. He heard God conversing with him in his own language. Now, I need you to see this. I need you to see the brilliance of God's diversity. He gathers 120 people, pretty much out of the same neighborhood. Because when you read it, they say, aren't all these Galileans? Not only are they Jews, but they're from the same neighborhood, the same same part of town. They're Galileans, which is a few miles north of Jerusalem. Aren't all these Galileans uneducated Galileans? Folk that have not been out of their own neighborhood Galileans? Aren't these folk that don't even have a passport Galileans? That are not cosmopolitans? That do not understand the diversities of nations because they've never been anywhere? Aren't these all Galileans? And how? Here we, every man in our tongue, in our own tongue, wherein we were born. They haven't been there, and yet they're speaking in the same intonation, the same cadence, the same phonetic emphasis. I went to Escuela Blitz because I wanted to learn Italian, and when they were teaching me some phrases, I said them. Lady looked at me and she said, "Ooh, you sound Italian." Said, "Yeah, I know." It's one thing to speak of the language, but it's another thing to sound like you know the language. Every man heard his own tongue. Thank you, thank you. Just, she gets so happy when I'm preaching. I'm just. Now watch what he says. Parthians, Medes, Elamites, dwellers in Mesopotamia, Judea, Cappadocia, Pontus, and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, in Egypt, parts of Libya, Cyrene, and strangers of Rome. They covered all of that with that 120. Because God is diverse. That word there in Corinthians, diverse, is the word diaresis. D-I-R-D-I-A-I-R-E-S-I-S. It means a distinction or variety. It means difference and diversity. God had 120 Jews from the same neighborhood in a room, and the Holy Ghost fell and spoke to every language and every nation. See, I know the problem. I know the problem. We limit the ability of God. And we think that the Holy Ghost and what God is doing is just for our little church and our little people. And, ooh, that was nice. Oh, no. No, it's universal. I know I got somebody watching me. He's a big God. Yeah. He's not just the God of the black man, the white man, the Asian individual. He's the God of every nation. When we read the Old Testament, we look at, I don't mean to hold you here. I'm just going to cut it off because I can preach for a long time, but I'm not going to try that on you today. When we look at what happened in Daniel, the book of Daniel, and we see in several places when Nebuchadnezzar was running the whole thing, and when the Cyrus and when Darius, they became king, they noted that they had 120 provinces. And those 120 provinces represented the entire world at that time. Which gives me to know that the interest of God was not just for a small group of people. For God so loved, he didn't say God so loved the Jews. It said God so loved the world. That was always the purpose of God. The purpose of God was every nation, every tongue, every dialect, every individual, so that no one is excluded. You got that? We'll say amen or I got it. When someone tries to make you think that God is so narrow and so small that the only folk that he can save are folk that look like you, think like you, act like you, dress like you, and get your approval. God is diverse. I know I'm beating that in because if we're going to do the job that God wants us to do, we're going to have to open up our minds. I've had opportunity to preach in various places around the world, and I had to preach to them. And they did not understand English. And I think I had the best time. I was in Holland. And I do not spreke the Dutch. I don't do that, and I probably said that wrong. And so they gave me an interpreter. And so I'm telling the interpreter. He said, I'm going to be, I said, all right. I greeted everyone. And I said, he's going to say what I say. And he interpreted. I said, and he's going to say it like I say it. And he interpreted, I'm going to say it like he said. So I got to preaching. And I said, and God said something. And he said, And whatever the word for God is, Jesus or whatever he said, and Jesus, I said, hold on. I didn't say that like that. I said, and God said, and he said, to hang. I said, now we got it. Now we understand. I need you to understand. I know I come from Detroit, but God knows me. I know I may holler, and I know I may tune it up, but it's all right, it's all right. God knows me, and I have the freedom of diversity in the Holy Spirit. I've seen people get saved in Africa. Seen them get saved and delivered in the UK. In Zimbabwe. Seen them get delivered in Ghana. In Kenya. And I'm preaching the same way I'm preaching to you. And the only reason I'm able to do it is because God loves diversity. It's a gospel of inclusion, but also diversity. But there is one caveat. You can be as different as you want, but you got to have the Holy Ghost. Yay. You may not operate the same way I operate. And I can't condemn you if you don't. You can't condemn me if you don't. Because there are diversities of operations. Diversities of administrations. You do it that way, I do it this way. She does it another way, he does it another way. That's all right. But you got to have the same spirit. Can't have an off-the-wall spirit. Spirit that does not resonate with the Holy Ghost. I'm through. You heard me say. I remember I was in Seoul, Korea on a Tuesday afternoon. I said, well, it's church day. Let's go to church. So me and Big Tony, we went to church. When I got to church, it was about 25,000 people at a Tuesday afternoon Bible class. May have been a little less. But I went there, and we got our seats, listening to the late Dr. Cho. When we got there, they had little stations where you could put on some earplugs, and whatever language you spoke, be it French, be it English, be it whatever you spoke, they had them, and they had interpreters that as he preached, they would... We're going to get there. I'm telling you. Because I've been exposed to it. I've seen how it works. I had my headsets on, and he was preaching in Korean. They was interpreting it in my ear. And I was who I was. I was Skippy's child. I was sitting in that back of the saying, my God, my God, my God. And then he slipped up and spoke in tongues. When he did that, I said, all right. And then he called on a prayer. And all those ministers got up and went to praying for people to be filled with the Holy Spirit. And I'm sitting in the balcony, Lord have mercy. And they went to praying. And when they went to praying, they stopped speaking Korean and went to speaking in their heavenly language. But this is what got me. They started stepping over the pews, laying hands on folk in the seat. I looked at Tony, I said, I know what that is. Because it's the same spirit. same Spirit. It's the same God which worketh all in all. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Stand to your feet. I'm finished. I ain't finished. I'm just gonna stop. Hear me when I tell you. I was in London some years ago. Pastor Ashimolowo from Nigeria used to have, I don't know if he still has it, but it was a conference called the Gathering of the Champions. And back there, he must have had, I don't know how many nations represented. And he asked me to come speak. Pastor McClurkin was with me. Hallelujah. I don't consider myself a great orator or even a great preacher. I just know what I've been called to do. And when I finished preaching the message, the Holy Ghost was there. I took off my jacket and went down into the auditorium and went to laying hands on all type of Europeans, Africans, some folk that was over in Ukraine, because I met some afterwards. And as I was laying hands and the Holy Ghost was meeting the needs, and they began to fall out under the presence of the Spirit of God, I said, "Donnie, come on, help me." And we went at it. I don't know how well I did in a homiletical presentation, but I know when the Holy Ghost showed up, people want to put you in a box, make you stay there. But God is diverse. Look at your neighbor and don't say a thing. Look at your neighbor and don't say a thing. Aren't you happy they don't look just like you? Don't laugh at them. Don't. I feel a breakthrough here for someone. Lift those hands. Father, let your Holy Spirit crown them with wisdom and understanding to know that you're the God of inclusion and diversity, but with the same Spirit, with the same Lord. For there is but one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God, who is the Father of all, who is above all, and who is in you all. Father, give us to know that you're going to do some great things through us in Jesus' name. Now, only if you believe that do I want you to give God praise and clap and shout. You can come. if you're tired. Come if you're burdened. Come if you're heavy laden. Come now, people, if you praise God, they will come. Come, come on, preach. Anyone today? Well, I'm different. We welcome differences. Well, I'm not of the same ethnicity. We welcome that. God bless you. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Our ushers are coming at this time, and I want everyone to give. I want everyone to give. Yeah, pray for her. Hallelujah. If you need an envelope, raise your hand. God is moving. And he's going to assign people. He's going to assign people to you that don't look like you, think like you, or act like you. I'll never forget, I was in Milwaukee, Wisconsin some years ago, and I was preaching. And they had invited this lady. And she had just gotten off the boat from Japan. And they asked her to have words. And she ran up to the front. I was sitting there and she looked. And she said, "I know no English. I'm from Japan. Just got here." Language different, spirit the same. That's the church that Jesus is coming back for. I believe that's the church he wants to see down here on earth. Hallelujah. I need somebody that believes that to give God a praise. If you want to be a part of that church, our ushers are coming. If you need an envelope, raise your hand. They'll be delighted to serve you. Thank you, Jesus. I want everyone to get a seat. Stand all over the sanctuary. I'm just happy that he included me. That I get to be a part of the Church of the Redeemed. Lift that seat up. Father, we honor you. We thank you for who you are and for what you're doing in our midst. Bless now both gift and giver according to their faithfulness and according to their cheerfulness. For it's not as a debt I owe, but as a seed I sow. Move your seed down to the end. The person on the end will remain standing.
We trust God with our finances. We give our tithes and sow our offerings. Perfecting Church has four ways to give. Cash App, $PC Detroit. Please add your name, address, and type of contribution in the notes. PC text to give is simple and very secure. Text perfecting to 73256. Online giving is available on our website at www.perfectingchurch.org. You may mail your contributions to Perfecting Church, 7616 East Nevada Street, Detroit, Michigan 48234. We pray Malachi 3:10 blessings upon you and your household. Thank you for your financial support to Perfecting Church.
Good day, members and friends of Perfecting Church. It is time for the Perfecting News. Perfecting Church will give away lots of food Tuesday. We will bless those in our 7 Mile and Woodward community beginning at 1 p.m. Spread the word. We have lots of food to give away. Volunteers, we always appreciate you. We pray you show up strong again. Thank you. September is right around the corner, and we know what September means at Perfecting Church. Soul winning! Sunday, September 3rd, is a day we always look forward to, Family and Friends Day. Get on the phone, send text messages to everyone you know, and tell them Perfecting is alive at 10:45. Come on, PC. Let's fill the house for Family and Friends Day. We're counting down the weeks to Day of Giving. Sunday, September 17th will be a historical day as we witness a day of unity. 1,000 people sowing $1,000. Members and friends of PC, let's strive to meet and exceed our goal. God will bless your want to's. Preparing us for Day of Giving is a day of stewardship. Saturday, September 16th at Perfecting Church. We are blessed to host Mr. David Stewart, one of the wealthiest men in the world. Ranked fourth billionaire on Forbes' list, David Stewart will share from his book, Doing Business by the Good Book. Doors will open at 10:30 a.m. for this in-person, life-changing forum. We love our cyber audience. If you're watching our services online and desire to join Perfecting Church, you can. Send an email to membership@perfectingchurch.org, and we will happily welcome you to our church family. We invite one and all to the Holy Ghost cleanse. If you desire an initial filling, or if your spirit needs to be revived, meet us here Wednesday at 7 p.m. You won't leave the same. Feel free to contact our church office if you have any questions. We are here to serve you.
Perfecting Church.